Oh, it's time to begin. Count down with me for the start of the radio broadcast.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Seminary proudly presents the Old Fashioned Revival Hour, a broadcast of the Gospel with Dr. Charles E. Fuller.
Thank you.
And will you pray with me, please? Dear Lord Jesus, we pray your blessing upon us this day. For those of us here in this place and for those all around the world who will hear your word. Bless that word in strength and in the truth that it is. And should any be hearing that do not know you personally, would you make that a new step in each such life? We'll thank you for that as we pray in the precious name of Jesus. Amen. And now we bring to you Dr. Charles E. Fuller.
Will you join us now in singing Heavenly Sunshine and lift it right up like you've never sung it before? We welcome people from all the way in the north at Prince Edward Island to the Belgian Congo. And we want to sing and bring some sunshine into everyone's life today. So let's sing it out like we've never sung it before. Heavenly Sunshine.
Heavenly sunshine, heavenly sunshine, light my soul with glory divine. Heavenly sunshine, heavenly sunshine, hallelujah, Jesus is mine.
Now, I've noticed in this great municipal auditorium, there were a few of you that didn't have smiles on your faces. We need to be singing the joy of the Lord and let it radiate with your smile on your faces. Let's sing it one more time.
Heavenly sunshine.
Thank you. And now listen as Rudy Attwood creates some sunshine with the piano. And now, beloved, may I share with you for a few moments on the topic of getting through the hardships of life. Whether you are a believer in the Christ Jesus or not, we all will face some hardships at some point in life. How to handle those hardships may make a difference for those who have been redeemed by the precious blood of Christ. You may be facing some serious illness, or some financial reversal, or a brokenness in your family relationship, or maybe a betrayal by a friend or fellow worker, or maybe even facing death itself. Are you content to face these hardships alone? Beloved, that need not be the case. In the famous words of the 23rd Psalm, David said, "Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me." Do you have that assurance that God is with you and for you and close beside you and even within you to help see you through life's hardships, even when facing death itself? My friends in this great municipal auditorium or out there in Radio Land, wherever you may be as you hear this gospel message, God wants to help see you through the struggles of life. And he will do it if you just let him. If you open your life to the compassionate care and saving power of the Lord Jesus Christ, you can have the assurance that come what may in life, you need not face it alone. Oh, how the words of 1 Peter 5, 6, and 7 can speak to our hearts. Beloved, listen to these words from God's holy word. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time, casting all your care upon him, for he careth for you. The choir is going to sing, "Does Jesus Care?" with the answer in the chorus, "Oh, yes, he cares."
Yeah.
old-fashioned revival hour quartet now comes to sing for you, Have a Little Talk with Jesus. If you tell Jesus all about your troubles, he will make it right. Now you will
find a little talk with Jesus makes it
right.
All right. I once was lost in sin, but Jesus took me in. And then a little light from heaven filled my soul. It bathed my heart
in love
and wrote my name above. And just a little talk with Jesus made me whole.
Now let us
have a little talk with Jesus.
Let us
tell him all about our troubles.
He will
hear our faintest cry,
and he will
answer by and by.
Now if you
feel a little prayer will turn it,
and you know
a little fire is burning,
you will find
a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
All right.
I may have doubts and fears, my eyes be filled with tears, but Jesus is a friend who watches day and night. I go to him in prayer, he knows my every care, and just a little talk with Jesus makes it right, all right.
Now let us
have a little talk with Jesus.
Let us
tell him all about our troubles.
He will
hear our faintest cry,
and he will
answer by and by.
When you
feel a little prayer will turn it,
and you
know a little fire is burning,
you will
find a little talk with Jesus makes it right, all right.
Now let us
have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about our troubles. Hear our faintest cry,
and he will
answer by and by. Now when you
feel a little prayer
will turn it, know a little fire is burning. Find a little talk with Jesus. Find a little talk with Jesus.
You will
find a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about our troubles.
You will find a little talk with Jesus
makes it all right.
Thank you. Gracious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, help me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious my call, hold my hand.
And now will you open your Bibles to the Gospel of John, the 15th chapter and verse 11. Hear these words of Jesus as recorded in God's holy word. These things have I spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full. One attribute that should be universal among Christians is joy. Did you know that the word joy appears 60 times in the New Testament, and the word rejoice is used 72 times? Now, I'm not speaking about a superficial joy, nor a joy that comes through gratification of our fleshly and carnal desires, but a deep and abiding joy which runs deep in our souls through knowing Jesus Christ as your personal Savior and Lord. Nehemiah of old said, "The joy of the Lord is my strength." And so it is, beloved. The promise of our Lord is clearly stated in John, the 14th chapter, verse 27. Hear these words from God's holy word as Jesus speaks. "Peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid." People in our day are looking for joy and peace in life, but many are often looking in the wrong places. The Apostle Paul in Galatians chapter 5 listed joy as nothing less than a fruit of the Spirit. Are you partaking of that fruit? The fruit of joy in your life? Oh, beloved, to know Jesus is to know real joy in your life. For he can walk with you and talk with you and tell you you are his own. And the joy you share as you tarry there, none other has ever known.
And he tells me I am his own.
Oh, how Mrs. Fuller and I enjoy receiving letters from all over the world from our listening audience. Honey, come and read the letters.
Thank you, dear. A precious letter from a mother of a fallen soldier. Dear Mr. Fuller, in a few hours the ambulance is coming to take me home in Salisbury, where a flag-draped casket is waiting with the remains of my only son, just returned from Europe, and where we will lay his dear body away. I felt I could not bear it, for my heart was broken, but I turned on your program, which seemed to be prepared just for me. Your choir sang, "Does Jesus Care?" And then, "Take Your Burden to the Lord." And then, "Wonderful." And then you gave such a precious message from God's book. How it thrilled my soul when you sang, "On that happy golden shore, where the faithful part no more, when the storms of life are o'er, meet me there." My burden is lighter because I realize more fully that I am not going to that service today alone, for God will be there and strengthen me. Let's remember this dear mother in prayer as she grieves for the loss of her only son. The second letter received is from a fine letter from an officer in the United States Air Force. Dear Dr. and Mrs. Fuller, in Bermuda, where I was stationed as an officer in the Hurricane Hunter Squadron of the United States Air Force, it was our wonderful privilege while making weather and hurricane reconnaissance flights out over the Atlantic on Sunday mornings to tune in to the WB-29 aircraft radio compass to the old-fashioned revival hour. My, how it would thrill my heart as we rode through the storms to listen to the message of the gospel and the grand old memories that are so precious to me as a Christian. Of course, in most cases, I was the only Christian aboard, and being the navigator, I was in charge of the broadcast band selection. Ha ha! So the whole crew had to listen, Christian and otherwise. Several times while flying into the very center of these severe tropical disturbances called hurricanes, as I was twisting the dial of the radio, the sweet voices of Mrs. Fuller and the quartet, and of course Dr. Fuller and the chorus choir were heard. It would thrill me to know that though the wild winds and storms raged all about me, I was anchored firm in the knowledge that I was kept in peace by the perfect love of Jesus Christ, my Savior. It was a dangerous assignment, but he carried us through safely. Let us also pray for God's protection over our brave servicemen and women who are serving our country. These letters that come in just move us so much. Thank you.
Wanderers on the mountain of strength.
Do those words of the choir speak to your heart today? If so, I plead with you to receive Jesus Christ as your personal Savior and Lord. God is speaking to you, unsaved friend. Surrender yourself to his saving grace. And now, with every head bowed and eyes closed, I invite you here in the auditorium to just simply raise your hand if you want to receive salvation, and I will pray for you. There's a hand over there and back there, and hands going up all over this municipal auditorium. Praise God for his saving power. And if you are by your radio, make that decision now and do not delay. For the Bible says that God is not willing that anyone should perish. Are you saved? Come now to Christ, and he will save you. Softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling, "You who are weary, come home." Earnestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling, calling, "O sinner, come home." Unsaved friend, don't let this opportunity pass you by. Here's your opportunity. Here is your choice to say yes to Jesus and invite him into your heart and know him as your personal Savior and Lord. Won't you make that decision this day?
Pardon for you and for me.
have made that decision to commit your life to Jesus, I want you to pray with me this prayer. Oh God, be merciful to me, a sinner, and save me for Christ's sake. Let the Holy Spirit of God come and dwell within my heart this very day and hour. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Thank you.
open your Bibles once again, this time to that time-honored truth from John's Gospel, chapter 3, verse 16. I would venture to say that many of you here in this municipal auditorium or sitting by your radio may have memorized this verse as a child. And I dare say it is a verse that will last you throughout your life for comfort, for assurance, that when you put your trust in Jesus, you make a reservation for a home in heaven. Now, if this is the first time that you have heard these words, take them to heart. Memorize it. Believe it. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And that everlasting life, beloved, is a promise for you to dwell in heaven. For Jesus said, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. For my Father's house there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also." This is a promise from our Lord. And my friend, you can have that assurance. When your journey on earth is over, you can have a home in heaven. Do you have that assurance? Listen as the choir tells us about heaven.
Thank you.
decision is up to you. What will you do with Jesus? Dr. Fuller's message is meant to bring you the assurance that when you die, you will be with the Lord. If you were not a Christian but responded to the Lord today, we'd be happy to hear from you. We also appreciate hearing from our regular listeners. You may contact us by calling Pacific 6374 or by writing to us at the Old Fashioned Revival Hour, 700 Locust Street, Pasadena, California. The Lord bless you as we leave the air. We appreciate hearing from our listeners. Take a few minutes to write us a letter and tell us you are listening and enjoying the program. It would be a great encouragement to us. Before we end the broadcast, the chorus will sing for you, Christ Returneth, which reminds us of the hope and joy of Christ's second coming. This old-fashioned revival hour was broadcast at Long Beach Municipal Auditorium. This is your host, Kurt Roberts, wishing you God's blessing until we return to you at this same time next week.